Hi. Tech Rabbit. Oh, here we are. Continuing the build of the MMU-2S. And now it's the idler bodily assembly that needs to be looked at. So let's have a look at the instructions. Now, if we've gone through the instructions, then we'll actually do it and do it with the parts. So anyway, we need to prepare the parts. And there's one bag with hardware and one bag containing the plastic bits. And I'll show that when we get to the parts. And step three is idler bearing assembly. So it's a stepwise process of inserting bearings and then putting a peg, steel peg or shaft in to hold them in place. Maybe three of them first on one side. And then we will rotate it, and then we'll put a couple more. And then we'll insert some screws into the end so we can actually connect it to the motor shaft. We'll put a bearing in place on the other side. Yeah, and then we need to actually make sure, I remember to make sure it's flush with the surface. And then there's some final checks to do, just to check that everything rotates, the screws are in place. And then we move on to the actual body. We need this hardware here, and the motor. Show that also physically. And then we need to insert some M3NS nuts. One on one side, one on the other. Make them sure they're lined up okay. And we actually need to insert the idler in the idler body. So we need to check that it actually goes in okay, and then it actually moves and it stops when it's supposed to be there. And then we need to add the extruder motor, so the shaft has got a edge cut into it, flat edge. So we need to align the motor up and insert it. And then also we have to make sure the cable comes out from the top with this orientation. And then we need to screw it in. And then from the bottom also. And then we need to tighten the screws for the shaft, and we need to be careful we don't crack the printed part. Also, we need to put in a shaft at the other end with a screw to hold it in place. And then it's horrible time, and then some final checks. So that's what we're going to work on now. And we can go look at the ports. You see with this here. So, okay, we have. Two bags, one is the idler body, contains these two plastic parts. Excuse me. Then we have the motor, which actually says, oh, if I could get it to focus. Come on. Idler. And it's in the motor box, which comes with the kit. And then we have a bunch of the bearings and screws and the axles. So that's it. So I think we get to work on it. So we got the hardware in the corner here. I opted to use this one Allen key to push in the axles. And yep, let's start. So let's see, the first step is to step three. That is to have check the or my printed part looks a bit different. These grooves they do not in the pictures in the manual, they don't exist, those groups. These ones here. But they probably found it was better to print it without the grooves, or easier to print if they took away some detail. But anyway, it won't impact the functionality as such. I'm just checking that the picture has the right orientation. And then that should drop in there. And then we need to put a shaft in there like that. And then we just need to push it right the way through. Oh, that was not so easy. Okay. It's not easy to press. Why? Has it come through to the bearing? Not really. No, it's kind of stuck. I hate pressing all these plastic parts too. Take my time and be careful with that. Okay, not the most fun thing to do, but I actually ended up taking this screwdriver, pair of gloves, putting it up, and then pressing down, actually quite hard, and then it went in with a crunch. But I don't think anything broke. Everything looks perfectly okay. There! Hope I don't have to do that with all the axes. That would be poor. Or stressful. It's the only... But anyway, I mean, of course. I could print out a new one. With my old printer. Make the old printer build a new one. Okay, but anyway, let's move on now. So just be expecting that that's quite hard to get in that axle. So that's just showing that, and then we should repeat it with the two next ones. Make sure this... Yeah, and then it was to make sure that the... it actually moves, which it does. So, next one. And it actually hung up just before it came through the hole for the bearing, so it wasn't actually touching the bearing. Let's see if this one will go in easier. Not fun. Okay. Really not happy putting that much force on this part. Okay, again, spend a bit of time doing this then. Okay, that also needed a bit more aggressive touch. And this one actually was a bit jammed up. But I mean, when I moved it backwards and forwards and rolled it backwards and forwards, then it actually freed up. So now it's perfect. But I make sure you free it up. So it's probably got stuck on the axle for a while. But as I said, that it doesn't seem to get stuck on the bearing. Like the bearing center is very easy. But it's in the actual, I think it's the edge of the print inside where there's a little notch where it gets stuck. Okay, then the next one. So, insert that. Okay. Oh no, that is so unfair. Can actually, I don't know if you can see it. See, I don't really want to show this. Let's get the light in there. See, it's just on the edge of the hole. Where it doesn't even really, it hasn't come through, really. Show it up. Real camera. Oh, it's just the lighting. Just trick it enough. Focus. Now you see. See, there! There now you can see. See, it's just on that edge where it gets caught. So it's not the bearing that's the problem, it's the print that it's created an edge. Or they created an edge when they printed it. Okay. So now it's in. Focus. And make sure you press the axle in enough so it doesn't extruding out to the surface. So make sure you get it in there. And I was able to push this against the table. I was able to hold the whole thing and push it against the table. But still the same edge effect. But the bearing seems to rotate okay. Well, that's the center bearing that I still think is a bit... It's not so free as... That one rolls, but this one doesn't. And it's free on the axle. Uh-huh, now. I get it free. Still tighter than the other one, but I don't think in this functionality it will make any difference. I mean, it's turning smoothly enough. Okay, that's step 3, and then we go for step 4, and then we have to turn it around in this angle like that. And then there's going to be two more bearings. We insert it. Start with that one. Probably the same edge roll. To the two and with the same system I've used to the other side. Yeah, that really took on the nerves. So I had to use this. I put it in, pressed it against the table, got it down so it was still a 2 millimeters out of this hole. And then I had to actually use this and really punch it down, and then it went in with a smack. Oh, it's a bit varying, these bearings. But basically, on my experience with bearings, I think they're okay. But they're not. Not all of them are picture perfect. I mean, even this free one doesn't rotate freely. Oh, a little bit different rotational quality. Well, I suppose we just have to... Right, comparing to the picture, looks okay. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bearings in place, so that should be okay. Almost nothing seems to be broken. Okay, moving on. Okay, now we need to put the screws in the end, or actually the flat nuts first. 1, 2, get them all in there. Look aligned. Yeah. And then we need to put the okay, so just to catch the nuts. It's quite a long distance to the axle. So I think there's no risk of over screwing them in, at least. Ah, can even see if they go into the or the axle. So screw that in. So see it that way. So that was step 5, step 6. And this was the last bearing. I need to put it in here. And let's hope that that will go in there. It's supposed to be flush, so it's not supposed to be extruding. Okay, let's see how flush. I don't know if it's possible to get it
completely flush.
To use the tabletop press down. Okay, I suppose. Oh, I just hate doing this with printed parts. But anyway, that is about as flush as we're gonna get. Like that. So I don't know, I wouldn't call it super. It's not flush and flush, but the actual picture, wait, hold on, see if I can blow the picture up. And see if we can see it better. Tolerances, thing. The angle they took in the photograph, it's very hard to see. But I would say that's flush enough. Yeah, let's call it a day. Let's say that that's it. Okay. So, next step. So that was step 6. Step 7's final check. So we should check that we have the screws in place, which are those two. Should make sure that all the bearings rotate reasonably well. I won't call them all of them perfect, but I don't think they're going to be technically causing any issues, any of them, because they're not sticking. And then we have the bearing at the end. So that's done. And then we're going to start working on this one. And for that we need the motor. And the rest of the screws. Insert exhaust. So this is step 8, is to get it prepared. Step 9 is to insert the flat nut. And that's here on the end. And then there's another one going to go in there. Well, let's get those installed. One in there. And the other one there. So that went relatively easy. And then let's see where we're supposed to next. Okay, so there. Align. Okay, then we need to orient like that. And then we need to take this. Not easy to see. Supposed to go in. Just a sec. Just looking at, trying to look at the picture to figure out. Orientation. Oh, well, they're putting it in. With the screws down. Okay. And then we're supposed to use the fingers, rotate the idle back and forth, and so smooth movement. Some friction rubbing between the parts is acceptable. Yeah, it does that. So now we're supposed to like rotate it. Yeah, well, some rubbing. Well, of course, it's not supported by the axles or bearings, so. So we shall see. And then it's jamming also on the screws at the end. It should look at least the same orientation as in the picture, right? Step 10 done. Okay, and then we need to line up. Something like that. Because here you see the axle at the inside there. It has a flat edge on it. Hard to see, but there is. Ah, there we go. So you see, there's a flat edge. So we need to orientate it like that. And then basically, we need to make sure the axle, when it's going to go in like this, has the flat edge at the same angle. Okay. I'll say something like that. And then we need to make sure the cables are going up. And we need to insert the motor. See how easy it'll go in. Oh, it's a bit tight. And don't break the part. Oh, I would doubt these screws are getting in the way. Move them out just in case. Okay, let's see now. The idler body necessary. Just the roller shots matched up. Sure, the cable from the motor's facing outside the two screws. The opening tighten them slot. Well, this shaft is, even though if it is, which it is correctly aligned, if one looks at the screws and then the flat edge and the screws do match, but that is not going to go in there very easily. And to force it would not be very nice. It's got quite a lot of supporting plastic here. Just like doing this forcing stuff. Well, this is the problem with printed parts. It's not perfect. Put it onto the table. Yeah. Yes. So having it against the, this is not very, this is not hard, this is a soft surface. But anyway, I got it in by supporting it here and then pushing the axle down. So I think it's in enough now. We're gonna get some screws in. So let's see now. So that'll be the top screws first, and the cable comes out the top. Just put it in very loosely. Okay. And then just to do it from the behind also. Oh man, that's gonna be a crap to do. Where's that special? The special hand wrench, the ball edge, ball end, and then I have to fiddle in two screws. Why do I have one more screw left? Oh yes, because that's going to go with the axle. So. Axle and that screw belong together, actually. So we don't have any extra parts. Okay, so I will just do my best to get the screws in there. Okay, now we need to I got them in there now loosely, so now we need to tighten them in diagonally. So. Oh, I'm just gonna start here. Oh, tighten that one. And then go over here. And then I have to use the ball end of it. Tighten this one. So that seems to be solid enough. Okay, next. So that was step 12. And then we'll see. The printed part. Okay. warnings about cracking the print board, because now we actually, oh, they're warning us. I mean, they printed the damn stuff. Sorry, should not be so negative. Okay, so how much struggle are we gonna have putting this thing in? Yeah, this is the reality build show. Nothing's faked. This is how it actually is in reality. I'm gonna build stuff. So, I wonder if I should. Maybe I'll put the Allen key over here. Push. That wasn't that one. Oh, there. So, let's see. And again, we see that there's an edge. Okay. So, just going to have to try and push that very, very slowly. With time. Hope goes in. So, it went in with a thud. I pushed it with this one on the putting. Yeah, I put it on the table like that. Done. And I just gently pushed it in, and then it went thunk, thunk, and then disappeared. So, that's that done. Set the shaft into the idler body and align it with the surface. Good luck with aligning with the surface. Make sure the shaft reaches the... And rotate and apply eyebrows if not the eye. Okay, then we're supposed to ensure there's a bit of a gap. Yeah, there's a bit of a gap. Like, really hard to see. But I mean, if I feel this, I mean, it doesn't really feel like there's much other resistance than. Also, the thing is, you can actually listen. There's no way you can hear it on the mic. But if you had major chafing issues, you would actually hear it, in my opinion. So, and then we have to put the screw in. I'm actually going to look how far the shaft. What are they saying, that it should be flush with this shaft here? Should be flush with the surface. If we look at their own picture, it's also. Oh, come on. Just trying to show how deep it is. It's about that deep in, even in their picture, before they put the screw in. So crap with that. Screw this in slowly and carefully. We don't split the part. I don't know how they had the ideas that the part would get split. Okay, if somebody really screws it down, because you're not supposed to screw it in more than. Well, they actually don't show. It's to be a safety. And it doesn't actually show. In the final, on step 15, you actually can see that it's actually quite. It is actually fully screwed in. But I'm just going to feel how it feels, because this is just to make sure that that axle does not come out. So I'd like the head of that screw to be in the way of the axle, not really any deeper than that. Yeah, that'll do it. And then it's not coming out, that's for sure. Let's see if I can get it. Yeah, there we go. So about that deep, I think would be perfect. Because then it's blocking, I mean the axle can't come out. Okay, so I had to cheat by looking at the last picture to be able to see the situation. So that's 13 we're on now. And oh, then we have to tighten in these screws here for the axle. Oh, and you can actually, they go in very easily. Actually feel it taking on the axle. And don't tighten these like crazy because they're, it's going to pull out the plastic. So about, you know, some reasonable amount. And then they're really super scared of people cracking the back of the plastic. Well, you know, gee, make better tolerances. Talking about like the way I had to force those axles in. Oh, stressing us out with that kind of stuff. Okay, and then final check is just to look at it. Surely the axis rotates, feel and rotates limited by the stops. Then it should be smooth. So where are the stops then? Is it like, ah, look, there. So, shut. So there's like one stop, so when it hits that edge there. Can't really see it, I suppose. Like that, so there. And then when we, what stops it if we rotate it on the other angle then? Okay, then it, yeah, then it kind of comes from the other direction and jams, like there, on the edge there. So, okay, I suppose we can, and it does feel like the only restriction for the rotation is the stepper motor, based on my experience of stepper motor feelings. And then what's this then? Make sure to, or in, okay, wants to make sure we didn't lose the flat nuts we put in. That looks okay. Where's the other one then? Okay, it isn't on the table. Oh, I'm gonna see a metal. Let's see. Yeah, it's still there. So, I made sure that both of those are, which is that hole. So, yeah. That hole, and that hole, just to make sure that the flat nuts are still there, that they're being knocked up. And it's, I would say after the final check. They got the Haribo's instep 14 before the final check. I think that's wrong. You should do the final check before you have. I give my Haribo's to my kids, so I actually don't have any. Okay. So anyway, that was quite good, I hope. Let's check the list and see if there's any anything that I've forgotten on this bill. No, I think this for this section. Anyway, if you like this one, consider subscribing. Hit the bell icon because there's going to be more parts. Inform others that are struggling with the same thing. And it's actually some of the interesting things we had is the, how difficult it is to actually put the parts together. And as I said, this is real life build. This is not, you know, do it off screen and then everything's fantastically okay. But enjoy it anyway. I enjoyed building this stuff, even if it's sometimes a bit aggravating. Anyway, I'll see you in the next one.